data upon which she relies is scientific and...
Objection overruled. You may continue.
I'm sorry, go ahead.
Can you repeat the question?
Certainly. The example in your PowerPoint shows the darkened portion much closer to the tip than the darkened portion in Q12, doesn't it?
I haven't directly compared them. It may be closer. This may be a hair that was further along in decomposition. This is just a photograph from the PowerPoint presentation that we use in the school.
For the edification of the court, is this a PowerPoint presentation for the, as a result of teaching, or is it a PowerPoint presentation relative to this case, just for my edification?
I believe the PowerPoint presentation was presentation that you were giving prior to the deposition to other individuals. Is that correct?
The pages that were provided to you, I just put together for this hearing. This particular slide is used in our introduction to hair and fiber school. So this photograph of the hair, which is labeled postmortem root band, I took from the school that we teach. The remainder of it was put together for this hearing today.
The problem I have with that, Your Honor, is we requested the actual PowerPoint presentation that she was using to teach on this topic, and I assumed that's what this was. So we don't have that PowerPoint presentation. And if she's teaching something different, or there's something that may be exculpatory or cast doubt on this particular procedure, it was my understanding that we were going to be getting that PowerPoint presentation.
I believe, and I know counsel was not involved in the case at the time, but I believe that those were provided to Ms. Bodden or Mr. Baez. I believe, again, since this was not raised until just now, I haven't had a chance to go back and look, but my recollection is that Ms. Wolf provided a number of items that were requested during depositions of a number of analysts. So I think counsel might want to go back and check, because I think you may have received it over a year ago. Though, quite frankly, I haven't looked. My recollection is things were provided.
I was just trying to understand why that particular PowerPoint presentation was prepared. It has answered my question. Let's move on, folks.
All right, just for the record, Your Honor, I don't believe we received it, and we had requested the PowerPoint presentation that she's using to teach, so if we could put that under the rubric of the other things we need at some later date.
May I add that? Something, please?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
The PowerPoint presentation that is used at the school, postmortem root banding is touched on in the microscopic characteristics in hairs. So this is the slide that is used for postmortem root banding. The remainder of the PowerPoint presentation for that particular section just talks about characteristics that are used to determine whether or not a hair is Caucasian or the body area. So this essentially is the PowerPoint presentation for this particular topic.
So there's no other slides out
there? As far as from the school.
Well, in terms
of... I'm sorry?
In terms of the PowerPoint presentation that you put together that you used prior to your deposition, there's no other slides that have anything to do with hair decomposition. Is that correct?
This is the slide that's used during that school.
All right, but there's
And again, it's just one topic within the microscopic characteristics.
But there's no other slides that you're using having to do with a hair decomposition other than the ones that you have provided. Is that correct when you're teaching? There's no other slides on that topic?
Correct. This is what I pulled from the talk that we give at the school that we teach.
Am I given to understand that you have never testified in a case in which you have rendered an opinion that a single hair with what you would call apparent decomposition would allow you to reach a conclusion that it came from a deceased individual, a single hair?
Well, one, I have not testified to this, and two, my conclusion would never be that it came from a deceased individual, only that it was consistent with either postmortem root banding or some other characteristics of decomposition, and that it would be consistent with coming from someone who is deceased, but my opinion would never be that it absolutely was.
All right, and you sent an email on August the 1st to...
Objection, not relevant to the issue of general acceptance. Seem to be going into generalized cross-examination.
Your Honor...
Well, just a second. Let me hear the complete question before you object. It's kind of hard to rule on it when I haven't heard the complete question. So, Ms. Lowe, before you answer the question, wait to see whether or not there's an objection. You may continue with your question.
I believe the email said, I can't say absolutely that the hair came from a dead body, but is consistent.
Objection, relevance and improper impeachment since it's consistent with what the witness just said.
Mayor.
Overrule, she can ask the question. Ma'am, did you hear the question?
That is what the, yes, Your Honor. That is what that email says, and again, that's what I just testified to.
All right. You also sent an email indicating, as I understand it, if there are, on that same date at 3:59, if there are vacuuming, I'll take them. If I find more than one hair.
Objection. Relevance.
Okay. Sustained. Let me read something to y'all that is cited in U.S. Sugar versus Henson on Frye. Under Frye, the inquiry must focus only on the general acceptance and scientific principles and methodology upon which an expert relies in rendering his or her opinion. That's the focus of this hearing. I'm hearing very few questions now concerning whether or not the general acceptance of scientific principles or the methodologies she utilized in reaching her opinion. It sounds more like a deposition rather than a Frye hearing. Please keep that in mind. And the quote is taken from U.S. Sugar versus Henson, 823-7-2nd, at page 110 of the opinion. Objection sustained. Next question.
All right, Your Honor, if I may just briefly respond that this motion isn't just a Frye hearing. There are other areas that we're seeking to have this testimony excluded, which includes...
Then you need to file another motion and we hear it. But the purpose of these hearings, which I set many, many months ago, was to deal with a Frye hearing. And I don't know how many times I can say that. These are Frye hearings.
With regard to the procedure and the conclusions having to do with apparent decomposition, as I understand it, you communicated in an email that the case would be stronger if you had more
objection,
than one.
Relevance.
Sustained.
There were multiple hairs that you examined, and only one, I believe.
Objection. Relevance.
Wait till she finishes answering the question, Mr. Ashton.
Only one resulted in an opinion by you of apparent decomposition out of all the hairs that were examined. Is that correct?
Objection. Relevance.
Reply.
Your Honor, as part of the Frye challenge, if we're looking at a procedure wherein multiple hairs are examined and only a single hair is found by an individual observer to have characteristics of what is called apparent decomposition, that goes as to the credibility of the whole process.
Credibility of the process is not an issue in Frye. The issue is the general acceptance of scientific principles and methodology.
I will permit her to answer the question, but again, you can answer the question, ma'am.
Yes, a single hair was found with characteristics of apparent decomposition.
But the question actually was that there were multiple hairs and there was only one that was found, in your opinion, to have that, correct?
Correct. A single hair was found with characteristics of apparent decomposition.
When this process of making this determination occurs, in this case, you were contacted initially before you undertook to observe the hair known as Q12. Is that correct?
Objection. Relevance.
Sustain.
In this case, you do not know what other items the particular hair may have been exposed to,
objection.
Correct?
Objection. Relevance.
Sustain.
This process known as root banding that we're discussing here today, no one, well, let me ask you this. Are you aware of an article that is published that indicates that a single hair using this process can be used to determine with any degree of scientific certainty that one can conclude it came from a deceased individual?
Objection. Could counsel identify the article for the record and for counsel by name and author?
I'm asking her if she's aware of any that allows one to draw that
Overrule.
Conclusion.
Overrule.
Are you aware of any article that... I'm sorry. Would you like for me to rephrase it? I know it's hard.
No. I just wasn't sure if you were finished asking.
Go ahead.
I'm not aware of any article, but again, the conclusion drawn by a hair examiner would be whether or not there are characteristics which were consistent with some sort of decomposition, whether it's postmortem root banding or putrid roots, and I don't believe an opinion would ever be that that hair came from a deceased individual, only that it was consistent.
And is it your testimony, or has it been your testimony in deposition, that the condition known as postmortem root banding has to be at the root?
It is at the root end. There is typically some distance in the literature. It's half a millimeter from the tip of the root to the band.
When you say at the root portion, are you saying including the root portion or adjacent to for this process?
Objection. Relevance.
Overrule.
This characteristic, again, is seen at the root end. It's not at the very tip of the root. There is root material between the tip of the root and the band. The literature talks about there being approximately half a millimeter. This band appears approximately half a millimeter down from the tip of the band, so that entire area I would consider the root end of the hair, but it's not at the tip of the hair, if that makes sense. In the photograph that was included in characteristics, which would be considered a putrid root, that very end of the hair would be where the decomposition was noted. In this picture, again, just from a class, it doesn't have to do with this case. There is some distance, so there is root present on the other side of the band as well. So that entire area, I would consider the root area.
All right, and can you, for example, for this case, draw a picture of what you consider for postmortem root banding, what constitutes the root and what constitutes the shaft on that photograph?
Again, I was asked that in deposition, and I was hesitant to on a photograph because that area could be more accurately determined using a microscope as opposed to a photograph. The root area would include the band, the dark band that was noted, but on the portion that it joins the shaft, I couldn't tell from a photograph where I would consider the root to end, or
well,
the root area to end.
For this process known as postmortem root banding, in order to determine whether or not this particular hair actually falls within the category that you are referring to, we need to know where the root is and we need to know where the shaft is. And as I understand your testimony, you're not comfortable identifying on the photograph what constitutes the root and what constitutes the shaft so that we can determine where that darkened period actually lies. Is that correct?